Welcome back. Today I'm going to talk about erectile dysfunction or impotence. My name is Dr. Deepak Kelkar. I'm psychiatrist, sexologist, de-addiction specialist and hypnotherapist practicing in Akola, Maharashtra, India. Today I'm going to talk about a very common sexual problem, that is erectile dysfunction or impotence. The problem of these diseases, or the people who are having this problem, they complain of that they are unable or they are not able to attain or maintain erection so that they can complete the sexual act to the satisfaction. So they are either unable to attain the erection or they are unable to maintain erection. So if they attain the erection, then they are unable to maintain erection throughout the sexual intercourse, and before completing or before ejaculating, there is loss of erection, or in between intercourse there is a loss of erection, or some people don't get erection at all. 2 to 4% of people at the age of 35, they are having this problem. So quite a big one. 77% people at the age of 80 years, they are having this problem, erectile dysfunction, unable to get erection. And in general population, recent studies show that in general population, around 8% people have got this problem of erectile dysfunction. And erectile dysfunction is constituting around 35 to 50% of all sex disorders. So the cause may be psychological or physical. Physical I am not going to talk much about, because majority of the cases, you know, the cause is psychological. If the person is coming to you, say before 40 years of age, for the first time he is getting this, and he is below 40, is more likely that it is psychological impotence. But if coming after age of 40, then we have to investigate and find out what is the physical problem or what is the organic problem. Is there any problem of arteries, like there is arteriosclerosis due to diabetes mellitus, or is a problem because of the hypertension, or there is a nerve damage, or there is some other disease, or like a lot of fat on the belly, you know, or unable to move on, or some joint problems, you know, something or the other, like. But majority of the times it is psychological impotence, and the causes are fear or anxiety or anger or some moral inhibition or prohibitions. The thing is, if it may be a lifelong psychogenic impotence, means like he has not attained erection at any time up till now. So it is lifelong. And another is acquired, which is most commonly seen. Acquired means like earlier he had erection, but now it is acquired. Now he doesn't have any erection. It may be generalized psychogenic impotence or erectile dysfunction, or is a situational one. Generalized means that no time is able to perform. Generalized one. Situational is with at some situations unable to perform. Like he may be able to perform with his girlfriend or a prostitute, but unable to perform with his wife or vice versa. So it may be psychological, as I said, or it may be organic. So we have to investigate and find out. Most of the time it is psychological one. The thing is, what is the cause? The cause is like, there is a loss of trust with the partner, or there is like loss of love, you know, there is no love between because of the frequent quarrels, then there is no intimacy, like a lot of interpersonal problems, you know, in the family or between husband and wife. Then there is like difficulty going on between partners, there is a communication problem. Then like if person fails at one time, then he has got anticipatory anxiety, like next time whether he will be able to perform or not. Then he is very tense and anxious for the next performance. And with the past failure, now he is very tense and anxious, like he may not be able to perform, and then he fails. Because I always say, you know, that you can have tension at one place only. Like in the brain, if there is a tension, there is no tension down. If there is a tension down, there is relaxation here. So now the psychogenic impotence may be due to many causes, like, as I said, psychological, but otherwise it is due to like blind faiths or illiteracy. Like people, they are having a problem, like they think that they have masturbated a lot, and that is why they have got loss of erection, or now they are unable to perform. So they have got myths about masturbation, or myths about nocturnal emissions. Like they have lost a lot of semen in the dreams, in the sleep, and now like he doesn't have any sexual erection, or there is no erectile, there is no erection in the penis. So the treatment is of medicines. Now there are a lot of medicines. In allopathy, there is a sildenafil, tadalna feel, varadana feel. Then if the medicine doesn't act, then we have got injection papaverin. But all these medicines or injections, they act only when the person, you know, has foreplay and he has got some sexual excitement, you know. Then only like he indulges in some foreplay or having intimate relationship, and like he has to prepare for himself, and then only he can get erection with these medicines. Now the erectile dysfunction may be due to depression or any other psychiatric illnesses or due to medicines if he is consuming any medicine. So now then we have to treat that cause first. But if it is psychogenic, then we have to have this marital counseling, like sex therapy, Masters and Johnson. Then I always advocate counseling, psychotherapy, and along with that hypnotherapy. And then like if there is a problem with situation, like situational anxiety is there, then like hypnotism or hypnotherapy helps, because then we make them visualize the act, and then he is relaxed during the act. He is visualizing the act under the hypnotic trance, and then he is relaxed. And also by that there is that situational anxiety will be cured. So there are a lot of people, you know, who are coming, but people who are coming at a young age, they are more. And in our country, like more people who are coming to us, they are because of the myths about sexual, like myths around sex, you know, like feeling guilty about masturbation, or like fail in the first night, for example, due to tension and anxiety, failed in the first night, and then like he has got tension and then he lost his erection. Or then he has got like basic loss of pleasure itself, you know, like loss of sexual interest, like from the beginning he doesn't have sexual interest. Then a lot of people who are having homosexual like attraction, and because of the homosexuality they don't have heterosexual intimacy, or they don't get erection with female partner. So then we have to investigate accordingly, you know, like finding out the cause, whether he has got homosexual inclination or not. So actually the treatment helps, and if you find out the cause, psychological cause or the organic cause, treat the cause, then the patient becomes all right. So as I said, there are 8% of the population in India, or like general population in the world, they are suffering from this problem. So my request is that you please circulate this video, spread this video, so that like more and more people come to know about the illness, like they have got some treatment. Otherwise what they do in our countries, like they go to like faith healers, or they go to the bus stand and purchase some books, or then they go to the advertisements which are seen in the local newspapers, and then they purchase those very costly medicines, and there is no relief, because they all this, you know, treatment, they don't go there and treat the like source of the illness. So if you circulate this video, like many people will be happy, they will be cured, and they can enjoy their sexual life. So thank you very much for watching the video. Thanks a lot.